everybody, how are you? Well, if you remember, we have been working with Tsarist Russia, so we dealt with Alexander II, and well, now you know that Alexander II was assassinated, and he was succeeded by his son, Alexander III. How do you think Alexander III felt with the assassination of his father towards the Russian people? He hated Russian people, especially the ones, the social class, which was charged with the assassination of Alexander II. But Alexander III, so he was a very strong man, and he was decided to reign with absolutism. He imposed autocracy. Remember that autocracy is also absolutism, but exercised not only by one person, but by a group of people. He imposed autocracy. He reigned from 1881 to 1894, and he took drastic measures, all connected with absolutism or autocracy. For example, he imposed the secret police. Any people threatening public order or being suspected of speaking against him were arrested and executed by the secret police. Sometimes they were exiled and tortured, and sometimes they were executed. So what was the purpose of exiling these revolutionaries? The purpose of Alexander III was to get rid of all revolutionaries. In fact, only a few revolutionaries remained in Russia. As regards education, if you remember all the measures that Alexander II had taken, well, in this case, Alexander III regulated all universities. Universities were regulated by the Tsar. All political activities at the universities were forbidden. They were banned. Secondary schools, well, secondary schools were completely different. They were just for an elite, because working class and peasant children were not allowed to attend secondary schools. As regards the press, there was a heavy censorship. Restrictions to the press were really, really hard. And if you remember, Alexander II had authorized kind of parliaments. They were the zemstas, that is the name in Russia, zemsta. They were local assemblies. So he didn't forbid, Alexander III did not forbid the zemstas, but he reduced the number of peasants and the number of intellectuals who were allowed to be in the zemstas. So they excluded them. Zemstas decisions were subject to be reviewed and changed by the provincial governors, and the provincial governors depended on the Tsar. The Tsar, Alexander III. Another important aspect to take into account with Alexander III is religion. He appointed Konstantin Povedonostev as the procurator of the synod, that is to say, the leading authority of the Orthodox Church. And in this synod, that is to say, it was like the Catholic Church, but the Orthodox Church, all religions were banned in the times of Alexander III. The followers of the different religions, especially the Jewish, were persecuted and killed. For example, the Finns and the Poles were assassinated in different massacres. Only the Russian Orthodox Church had the protection of the Tsardom. Another important policy that Alexander III imposed was Russification. The Russian language was enforced and compulsory. It was compulsory in different regions, as for example the Ukraine, that is to say the White Russia, Lithuania, Poland, and the Baltic provinces. And Alexander III, unfortunately, is famous for his anti-Semitism policy, much before than Hitler. There were massacres of Jewish and during his reign, And these massacres became part of the policy of Alexander III, especially, as I told before, in Finland and Poland. This policy was continued, unfortunately, by Nicholas II. He was known by the massacre in Kishinev in 1903. But we are going to speak about Nicholas II, the last Tsar in Russia, the last Romanov Tsar in Russia, in our following class.